Hey, I'm Marc Chipouras with Grafana Labs. I'm head of emerging products here. Love observability. I hope you love observability too. We just came through with our third annual observability survey. Over 1,200 people responded. I want to kind of share some notes with you. The first takeaway from the survey is actually alert fatigue. 33% of you said it's the biggest obstacle to your incident response today. Spot on, everybody feels this. A lot of you actually thought it was about lack of incident response process as well. What's really good here is we're going through, it's not just the engineers that are having a problem with alert fatigue, it's everybody. Your CTO, your director of engineering, the platform team, everybody has a problem with alert fatigue. This is great, because if your leaders weren't having a problem with alert fatigue, then we don't have any chance of getting it fixed. EM's real challenge in this whole thing is not just alert fatigue. They're also having problems with coordination during their incidents. This is likely because we usually put them as the incident manager on call. So coordination and collaboration, their biggest challenge, everybody else dealing with those alerts. One of the things I think is most interesting is the best way, I think, to resolve some of that alert fatigue is to move to SLOs. And it's great to see that 24% of you are actually using SLOs in production today, and another 50% of you are actually in a POC or investigation for SLOs. What's awesome about SLOs, it actually facilitates this conversation between engineering and product to understand where you should be investing today, and all that conversation can happen in front of your leadership. Leads to better accountability. Long-term, it leads to better MTTR, which is actually 33% of you are using SLOs for MTTR, and 25% of you are using it for better accountability. Both of those are there in order to help reduce your alert fatigue as well. When we look into these numbers about alert fatigue and AIML, we're seeing that around 31% of you think that training-based adaptive alerts is the best way to reduce alert fatigue, where a bunch of people, around 28%, are actually thinking that faster root cause analysis is our best way in order to use AIML to reduce alert fatigue. Both of those are really interesting. When we slice and dice it to see who actually responded to this survey, we actually see something that's more fascinating here. Our leaders, our CTOs, our director of engineering all think that adaptive alerts for anomaly detection is a good way in order to reduce that alert fatigue. But the engineers among us, the engineering management platform team at SRE, actually think that faster root cause analysis and our automated checks is a better way in order to be able to reduce that alert fatigue. That's interesting to me. Is that our engineers that are closest to AIML actually see the benefits of where RCA or root cause analysis could go? Or is it that our leaders just don't have faith in AIML yet? I think it's interesting. Lastly, I want to talk a little bit about FinOps and actually using observability in order to do cost attributions. It's actually super critical to observe your observability costs so these don't overwhelm your overall development spend. Especially because not all observability is created equal. You have some teams who are using it more and some people are using it less based on the performance issues or the greenfield service that they're deploying. But 15% of people are actually using FinOps in production today. That's pretty predictable, and it actually gets the larger organizations are using cost attribution more in order to be able to send costs across departments. It's really important from my side that we increase transparency on observability costs, whether you're a small company or a large company. Highly recommend that you actually use cost attribution just to at least show back to teams what they're spending if you're not actually applying it back to their teams. Showbacks like that can actually dramatically change your organization and how you're using observability to improve your engineering department. This data is all available in an interactive dashboard for you to explore, slice and dice. AIML is changing so rapidly. I can't wait to hear more about how you're using it in order to be able to reduce your alert fatigue.